Weather outside's delightful, and the fire is so frightful. And if we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Ooh. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide.
Merry Christmas, City Sanctuary. Happy Sabbath. I'm glad you have chosen to join us whenever and wherever you are. We are all virtual today, enjoying our families and our couches. Yes, I'm standing outside and currently freezing, but it's worth it because there's snow behind me. It's beautiful and there's more coming. I am not local right now. I'm actually up in Canada at my parents' house. Very, very thrilled to be here. I hope you are with you and with yours and enjoying the holiday season. It's Christmas Day. So cool that it's Sabbath and Christmas Day. I don't have a ton to say because it's Christmas and we're going to get straight to it. But we've got some special things in our program today. But I am going to read a couple things before I start. I do want to just say we are planning to be in person and on our stream next week, our usual. But if there's any impending snowpocalypse or ice storm or any weather that will make it unsafe for us to be together at the Holden Center, we will let you know, but you need to pay attention to your email. Patty will send an email blast out if we need to make any changes to that schedule. I will also post stuff on social media. So the address was in the usuals, which was very short. So pay attention to that in case we have to make modifications to next Sabbath. But hopefully we will be together at the Holden Center on New Year's Day. So with that, oh, I forgot to say, I just looked down. Can you see it says Meowy Christmas? Meow, meow. Okay. I'm going to read a few things for you, a couple passages and then a few excerpts from the Book of Common Prayer. So here we go. I'm going to read John 1, verse 9. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. Revelation 22:5. And Stephen read this last week, but I'm going to read it again. Night will be no more. People will not need the light of a lamp or the light of the sun, because the Lord God will give them light, and they will reign forever and ever. Revelation 22, verse 5. This story didn't begin with a baby in a manger, and it doesn't end there either. Light isn't diminished when we put away the Christmas tree or blow out the last Advent candle. Christmas Day is a celebration of the start of Jesus Christ's life on earth, his ministry, death, and resurrection, and the new life he invites us to enjoy. His work in driving out darkness and making all things new is both already accomplished on the cross and still ongoing. Until Jesus Christ returns, we share in his work as people of the light, eagerly awaiting that promised day. All right, and then a couple prayers. So this is a prayer for Christmas Day. Oh God, you have caused this holy night to shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that we, who have known the mystery of that light on earth, may also enjoy him perfectly in heaven, where with you and the Holy Spirit he lives and reigns, one God in glory everlasting. Almighty God, you have poured upon us the new light of your incarnate word. Grant that this light, enkindled in our hearts, may shine forth in our lives through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Merry Christmas. I hope you have a wonderful day with whomever and whatever you're doing. I'm excited to see you next week. Thank you again to those of you who helped put on last week's Christmas program. If you want something else to watch this week, go back to the 18th live stream that we have on our YouTube channel and enjoy that. It was a great program. And let's say a word of prayer before we get started. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for your gift and your sacrifice, and that we have hope in you. Be with us as we celebrate today. Be with our families. Be with everyone in all the various places we are. Thank you for the hope that we have in you and the light that you are. And thank you that the dark stays here. We love you. Amen. Merry Christmas. Peace. Pause. Joy.
Good morning, Digger. Why are you jumping up and down? Because it's Christmas. Yes, Christmas is a very exciting day. I woke up this morning and I had stuff in my stocking. What was in there? Oh, the usual. Socks, an orange, coal. Coal? That is what bad children used to find in their stocking. That is what I thought. I pulled it out and thought I had been bad. Turns out it was hard black licorice. Yum. I thought you were a little black around your mouth this morning. Did you open the present I gave you? I did. Thank you for the special tulip bulbs. I am sure they will be beautiful in the spring. If someone doesn't eat them first, where did you get them? I'll never tell. Let's just say they weren't purchased in a store. Digger! So, did you open the present I gave you? Oh, yes. I could hardly wait until this morning to open it, but I did. You gave me one of my favorite things to snack on, tulip bulbs. I will think nicely of you when I am munching on them. How funny that we got each other tulip bulbs. Besides getting presents, there is a better reason to celebrate today. Besides presents? What could get better than that? The reason we celebrate today is that Jesus came to earth to save us. We don't know when exactly he was born, but we celebrate his birthday today. You say Jesus came from heaven as a small baby to live with us and save us? Yep. Crazy idea, huh? But that is what happened. Jesus came down as a baby and grew up and was sacrificed on the cross so he could take all of our sins. Are you all right? This story keeps getting stranger every time you tell it. I am perfectly all right. And the only thing you have to accept this gift is to believe that Jesus did this for you. Then you have the gift of heaven. That sounds pretty simple. I think I will believe. What a special day we celebrate. You are correct, Digger. Have a good rest of your day, and don't eat all of those bulbs at once. I might save one or two for tomorrow. Ta-ta! Merry Christmas, Digger. To those out in camera land, we hope you are having a good day with your family or friends. Merry Christmas.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the poor baby wakes, but little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay close by me forever and love me.
Once upon a time, in a sunny valley, there lived a little lamb named Joshua. He was white with black spots, black feet, and sad eyes. Josh felt sad when he saw the other lambs with snow-white wool and no spots. He felt sad when he saw the other sheep with their moms and dads because he didn't have a mom or dad. But he felt saddest when he saw the other lambs running and jumping because he couldn't. Josh had been born with one leg that didn't work right. He was crippled. He always limped when he walked.
That's why he always watched while the other lambs ran and played. Joshua felt sad and alone, except when Abigail was around. Abigail was Josh's best friend. She didn't look like a friend for a lamb. She was an old cow. She was brown with white blotches that looked like rain puddles on a path. Her belly was round as a barrel, and her voice was always kind and friendly. Some of Josh's favorite hours were spent with Abigail.
They loved to pretend they were on adventures in distant lands. Josh liked to listen to Abigail tell stories about the stars. They would spend hours on the hill, looking into the valley. They were good friends. But even with a friend like Abigail, Josh still got sad. It made him sad to be the only lamb who could not run and jump and play in the grass. That's when Abigail would turn to him and say, "Don't be sad, little Joshua. God has a special place for those who feel left out."
Joshua wanted to believe her, but it was hard. Some days he just felt alone. He really felt alone the day the shepherds decided to take the lambs to the next valley where there was more grass. The sheep had been in this valley so long, the ground was nearly bare. All the sheep were excited when the shepherd told them they were going to a new meadow.
As they prepared to leave, Josh hobbled over and took his place on the edge of the group.
But the others started laughing at him. "You're too slow to go all the way to the next valley. Go back, Slowpoke. We'll never get there if we have to wait on you. Go back, Joshua."
That's when Josh looked up and saw the shepherd standing in front of him. "They're right. They are right, my little Joshua. You better go back. This trip is too long for you. Go and spend the night in the stable." Josh looked at the man for a long time, and then he turned slowly and began limping away.
When Josh got to the top of the hill, he looked down and saw all the other sheep headed toward the green grass. Never before had he felt so left out. A big tear slipped out of his eye, rolled down his nose, and fell on a rock. Just then he heard Abigail behind him. And Abigail said what she always said when Joshua felt sad. "Don't be sad, little Joshua. God has a special place for those who feel left out." Slowly, the two friends turned and walked to the stable together.
By the time they got to the little barn, the sun was setting like a big orange ball. Josh and Abigail went inside and began to eat some hay out of the feed box. They were very hungry, and the hay tasted good. For a little while, Joshua forgot that he had been left behind. "Go to sleep, little friend," Abigail said after they finished eating. "You've had a hard day." Josh was tired, so he lay down in the corner of some straw and closed his eyes. He felt Abigail lay down beside him, and he was glad to have Abigail as a friend.
Soon Josh was asleep. At first, he slept soundly, curled up against Abigail's back. In his sleep, he dreamed. He dreamed of running and jumping just like the other sheep. He dreamed of long walks with Abigail through the valley. He dreamed of being in a place where he never felt left out. Suddenly, strange noises woke him up.
"Abigail," he whispered, "wake up. I'm scared." Abigail lifted her big head and looked around. The stable was dark except for a small lamp hanging on the wall. "Somebody's in here," Josh whispered. They looked across the dimly lit stable. There, lying on some fresh hay in the feed box, was a baby. A young woman was resting on a big pile of hay beside the feed box. Joshua looked at Abigail, thinking his friend could tell him what was going on. But Abigail was just as surprised as Josh.
Josh looked again at the woman and the child, then limped across the stable. He stopped next to the mother and looked into the baby's face. The baby was crying. He was cold. The woman picked up the baby and put him on the hay next to her. Josh looked around the stable for something to keep the baby warm. Usually there were blankets, but not tonight. The shepherds had taken them on their trip across the valley.
Then Josh remembered his own soft, warm wool. Timidly, he walked over and curled up close to the baby. "Thank you, little lamb," the baby's mother said softly. Soon, the little child stopped crying and went back to sleep. About that time, a man entered the stable carrying some rags. "I'm sorry, Mary," he explained. "This is all the cover I could find." "It's okay," she answered. "This little lamb has kept the new king warm." "A king?" Joshua looked at the baby and wondered who he might be. "His name is Jesus," Mary spoke as if she knew Josh's question. "God's son. He came from heaven to teach us about God."
Just then, there was another noise at the door. It was the shepherds, the ones who had left Joshua behind. Their eyes were big and they were excited. "We saw a bright light and heard the angels," they began. Then they saw Joshua next to the baby. "Joshua, do you know who this baby is?" He does now. It was the young mother who was speaking. She looked at Joshua and smiled. God has heard your prayers, little lamb. This little baby is the answer.
Joshua looked down at the baby. Somehow he knew this was a special child and this was a special moment. He also understood why he had been born with a crippled leg. Had he been like the other sheep, he would never have been in the valley, or he would have been in the valley. But since he was different, he was in the stable, among the first to welcome Jesus into the world.
He turned and walked back to Abigail and took his place beside his friend. You were right, he told her. God does have a special place for me.
Good morning, everyone. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. It's great to be with you here on our premier live stream. Today, we want to spend a few minutes thinking about one of the real stars of the whole Nativity story. However, he's probably the most obscure of all the players in the Nativity, and I don't think that's fair. So I thought we would take a look today, just for a few minutes on Christmas, about someone that I think is remarkable and probably a prime example of what it means to be a man. And of course, I'm talking, of course, about Joseph, the carpenter. I want you to turn in your Bibles with me to Matthew chapter 1. Matthew chapter 1. We're going to take a look at something that's very, very unusual. If it wasn't for Matthew, we would only have a very little bit in Luke that tells us about Joseph, the carpenter, who was Jesus' earthly father, okay? And so we're going to take a look at what Matthew says, and what Matthew gives us in the space of two chapters is something very remarkable. And I'm happy I can share it with you today. So let's take a look at Matthew chapter 1, Matthew chapter 1, and we're going to head into this little storyline that you all know very well, but we're going to develop a theme off of this first passage, okay? So let's just kind of follow the narrative. This is how Jesus Christ was born. Boom, just like that. A young woman named Mary was engaged to Joseph, there's his name, from King David's family. That's his roots, that's his lineage. He comes from King David's family, the tribe of Judah, okay? This is how Jesus Christ was born. A young woman named Mary was engaged to Joseph from King David's family. But before they were married, she learned that she was going to have a baby by God's Holy Spirit. Not by a man, but by God's Holy Spirit. Just within that one verse, Matthew sets up a drama for us to follow. Next verse. Joseph, part two about him, from the line of David, okay, engaged to Mary. Joseph was a good man. That's something that I would like to have said about me. I'm a good man. I'd like to hear that. I hope that's what my life's about. I hope it's for you too, men. And did not want to embarrass Mary. So he was a good man, didn't want to embarrass Mary in front of everyone. So he decided to quietly call off the wedding. Engaged to be married. He's quite a bit older than her. Mary's maybe 17, maybe 18. I don't know. But she's not very old. She's a young woman. Okay? At some point, she goes to Joseph and said, I am pregnant. And Joseph says, oh, boy. Okay? So let's see what happens here. He's going to quietly call off the wedding, and then in verse 20, something happens. While Joseph was thinking about this, calling off the wedding, an angel from the Lord came to him in a dream. This is dream number one. Dream number one. angel of the Lord comes to Joseph in a dream, and the angel said, Joseph, the baby that Mary will have is from the Holy Spirit, not from another man. It's from the Holy Spirit. Okay? And the baby is going to have by the Holy Spirit. Verse 19. Let's go to verse 19. Okay. Joseph was a good man, did not want to embarrass Mary in front of everyone, so he decided to quietly call off the wedding. Verse 20. Just backing up for a second here and get our groove going. Verse 20. What does that have to say? While Joseph was thinking about this, an angel from the Lord came to him in a dream. The angel said, Joseph, the baby that Mary will have is from the Holy Spirit. Go ahead and marry her. Marry Mary. Okay? Marry Mary, Joseph. That baby's from the Holy Spirit. Okay? Gave him this dream. Okay, verse 21. Then after her baby is born, want you to give this baby a name. The father called the name out. Name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. A dream. Mary, Mary, Joseph. The baby's from the Holy Spirit. And when he's born, call him Jesus, because he will what? Save his people from their sins. Verse 22, check this out. Verse 22 and 23. So the Lord's promise came true. Just as the prophet had said, a virgin will have a baby boy, and he will be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. Jesus comes and he brings God with him in his birth, okay? God is with us. Next verse, verse 24. After Joseph woke up, what happened? And this is the thing about Joseph. If there's one trait about him, the guy's a man of action, and he's not afraid to take charge. He's not afraid to make things happen and make them happen quickly. It says here, after Joseph woke up, he and Mary were what? Soon married. Just as the Lord's angel had told him to do. Okay, that's part one. Angel comes to him in a dream. I know she's pregnant, but it's from the Holy Spirit. Go ahead and marry her. And when the baby's born, you call him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. And when he woke up, he and Mary were soon married. He didn't wait around. Didn't wait around for her to start showing too much. He got it and married her right away. That's a man of action, just based on a dream. A dream. Okay, let's go to the next passage. Matthew 2, verse 13. Who's our star today? Our star is Joseph. After the wise men had gone, the wise men came and worshipped him, gave him gifts. After the wise men had gone, an angel from the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, get up. Get up. Hurry and take the child and his mother to Egypt and stay there until I tell you to return, because Herod is looking for the child and wants to kill him. The three wise men had a dream themselves and did not go back to Jerusalem. They skipped Herod, didn't tell him anything. Angel gives Joseph dream number two. Dream number two. And what does he say in this dream? Get up. Joseph, wake up, get up, hurry and take the child and his mother to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you to return. All right, next verse, verse 14. That night. When? That night. That night, Joseph got up and took his wife and the child to Egypt. where he stayed until Herod died. So the Lord's promise came true. Just as the prophet had said, I called my son out of Egypt. This star, Joseph, when he was told to marry Mary, the Bible says he married her soon. He got right with it. In this second dream, the angel says, get up, hurry, and get out of here and go to Egypt. What does he do? He wakes up in the moment, rubs his eyes. He's had this dream, and he goes and he wakes up Mary. Said, Mary, let's pack some diapers. Let's get what we got to get, and we're out of here. And not only does he have to leave Bethlehem, puts her on a donkey, and there's baby Jesus with her, and they're on their way to Egypt. All one dream, gets up, makes his move on the way to Egypt. That's dream number two. Let's go to the next verse. That's verse 8:19. Matthew 2:19 says something interesting too. Once again, after King Herod died, who wanted to kill baby Jesus, an angel from the Lord appeared in a what? Dream. A dream. That's dream number three. Joseph gets these dreams. These amazing dreams. There's something about Joseph. He hears the dream, he has the dream, and he acts on it. It says here, after King Herod died, an angel from the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph while he was still in Egypt. They'd made their move to Egypt, and now he's in Egypt, he has another dream. Next verse. The angel said, get up and take the child and his mother back to Israel. The people who wanted to kill him are now dead. Get up, Joseph. Time to go back. Go back to Israel with your child and the mom. And the people who wanted to kill him are now dead. Verse 21. What did Joseph do? Now, it doesn't say that he left immediately, but it really gives you an idea that he left very soon. It says Joseph got up and left with them for Israel. I'm thinking he gets up, he wakes up Mary, says, we got to start packing because as soon as the sun comes up, we're heading back to Israel. I had a dream. A man of action. Dream number one, go ahead and marry Mary. He married her soon. Dream number two, get out of here. Go to Egypt. Herod wants to kill him. Gets up immediately and he goes. Go back to Israel now. Joseph got up and left with them for Israel. Three dreams. Joseph the carpenter. He's a star. Is that it? Well, let's go to verse 22. In verse 23. But when he heard that Herod's son, Archelaus, was now the ruler of Judea, he was afraid to go there, Herod's son. Judea. Judea was Bethlehem. He was going to go back to Bethlehem. Egypt to Bethlehem. He went from Bethlehem to Egypt. Egypt back to Bethlehem. Well, then he had a dream. Then in a dream, that's dream number four. Dream number four. Then in a dream, he was told, you go to Galilee. And what happened? They went to live there in the town of Nazareth. He gets a dream. He's already left Egypt. He gets a dream. He gets the news that the king's son is in Judea, worried about the child's life. He's taking care of business. He gets a dream that first night. First night, he says, nah, but don't go to Judea. You take him to Galilee. They get up the next day. They change course. And they start heading to a town called Nazareth, which was about 90 miles away. So the Lord's promise came true. Just as the prophet had said, he will be called a Nazarene. We don't know much about Joseph, friends, before Matthew tells us this story. We know very little. We know very little about Matthew. About Joseph after Matthew's passage, with one exception, that when he went to the temple at 12, his father and mother were looking for him. But Joseph is a star. I haven't had four dreams. I haven't had one dream from an angel. He had four. And when he had those dreams, friends, he acted on it immediately. That's a special man. That's a man I wanted to talk about today on Christmas Day. He really took care of Mary. He took care of Jesus. He's the kind of role model that we men need. Merry Christmas, everyone. Let's have a prayer. Our Father in heaven, thank you for the story of Joseph. We're going to add him now in there with the shepherds and with the wise men and with the whole story, because he's the guy that has the dreams. And he's the guy that when he has a dream, he gets up and he acts on it. That's a major, major player, Lord. And I pray that we will respect him from now on. Respect his life, his journey, and the contribution he made to our Savior, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Merry Christmas, everyone. God bless you. We'll see you next year.
The manger and the cross. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned.
He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and familiar with suffering.
For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders.
Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us.
But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own town to register.
We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
The Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
He poured out his life unto death and was numbered with the transgressors, for he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors.
For unto us a child is born.
But he was pierced for our transgressions.
Unto us a son is given.
He was crushed for our iniquities.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light.
The punishment that brought us peace was upon him.
On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned.
And by his wounds we are healed.
The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us.
He was crushed, he was pierced,
and he rose again.
Merry Christmas.